Hello there, and welcome. My name is Dimitri Lylan, and I am a program manager on the .NET team. My focus is hot reload technologies and XAML tools, and today I'm here to talk to you about both in this video. So let's jump in. So what are we going to talk about today specifically? We've got three areas that we're going to cover, and we're going to talk about features in each area and how Visual Studio 2022 makes all of these things much easier to do as a developer. So first, we're going to talk about design experiences. This is about things in your XAML designer. Since this video is for XAML developers, we're going to look at how XAML designer has evolved to become a great tool for you to be productive. We'll also look at the code editor as well as we go out through the different demos. Then we'll look at diagnostic tooling and live editing. We have a lot of powerful features in Visual Studio 2022, things that allow you to understand what's going on with your XAML binding failures, the ability to do UI development and do everything from tweaks to major changes to your XAML, and even edit code behind. .NET Hot Reload, a new feature only found in Visual Studio 2022. And finally, we'll take a slightly different pivot at the end from the design side and show you how our XAML Live Preview experience makes it easier to design beautiful applications. We're going to do that by focusing on demos around these technology areas. We're going to be looking at, again, XAML Designer, Code Editor, XAML Binding Diagnostics, XAML Hot Reload, Live Preview, and .NET Hot Reload. So with that, let's jump into the demo. So here I have Visual Studio 2022 open, and I have a WPF app. So we're going to use WPF app for all of my demos today. So let's go and take a look what's new. The first thing I want to talk to you is about the design team experience. As we said in the intro, our designer has gotten much better. We've got a lot of improvements in it. We've looked at performance and its ability to render the XAML that you're building. And to have really the best experience, you do need one thing often, which is data in your designer. Because if there's no data, your designer, like I have here, looks very, very empty. And that's just not great, right? You have an application you're building. There's probably a bunch of content that goes right here in the middle. And if it's not there, it's hard to visualize your app without running it. So let's see how our design time data feature can make that better. So here I already have my design time data feature in action. Over at the top of my app, I have air quality. And the only reason I see this is because I have set the magical D colon property in my code editor. So here my normal text property for this text block is set to a binding. And because it's set to a binding, it's not going to display anything unless I go for the trouble of mocking a view model. But I no longer have to do that. With our new design time data, you can mock any property in any control. You can even mock controls by simply typing D colon followed by what you normally would type, in this case, text. So here I am able to see exactly what I want to see. And if, let's say, I want to test a much bigger title, I can do that. I can simply type it in, and I can already see what impact it's having in my application. But this is great and all, being able to set a text block. But what would be much better is to be able to actually view items. So let's take a look at my items control. So I have an items controls here, and it has a data template, so it definitely could show items, but nothing is showing up. So let's now bring in design time data in a much bigger way. So here, I'm going to show you a code snippet that I've commented out just for the purposes of this demo. So we're going to comment this back in a second and show you what it does. So here, as you can see, I'm using the D colon property to once again mock something. D colon will only appear in the designer when you build your app. None of this will translate to your running application. So I want to make sure you feel comfortable with using D colon for just design time. And in this case, I'm saying D colon items control item source, and I'm giving it a fake array of entities, which will create the visual. Let's go ahead and see that magic in action. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to uncomment this code, and it's going to be very quick, right? Right away, we see, let's zoom in a little bit, we see items appear in the item template. And here I've mocked the data. So let's say I want to play with what the data says. Let's say I want to see what happens at the bottom here. Will this data overflow? Is it wrapping correctly? So let's go ahead and play with it. Will this data overflow? I'm going to add that, save it, and then I'm going to hit this nifty little refresh button we've added. And by doing that, as you can see, it's not wrapping properly. It's not something I'm going to go fix right now, but I just wanted to show you the power of just like quickly being able to mock entities, set the values, and have something that went from being a blank designer to a much more rich designer. I kind of joke, it's like hot reloading the designer. Of course, it's not really hot reload, but I hope you really see that this feature is super powerful to make things easy. So now that I have my entities being listed here, being visualized here, I'm going to go ahead and show you one more feature that we really love. And again, it's a new feature in the designer. I'm going to alt-click into good a few times till I get in my XAML to the text block that's representing this inside of my data template. Now here, I already know I have a bug. My designer told me that this value should always be bold, and it's not bold. And with this, I want to show you a brand new feature called XAML Quick Actions. XAML Designer Quick Actions. With XAML Designer Quick Actions, we show you common properties for the control through a little light bulb that appears. And when you click the light bulb, we expand and show you all the common properties. We give you visualizations for setting horizontal, vertical, change sizes, and we know which properties people often use on controls that we create, so we're able to show it to you. All right, so I'm gonna have to open this up again because I just zoomed. So I'm gonna open it up again and set this bold property right here. So I'm gonna hit bold. And look at that, all the items went bold because this is a data template, right? It's reusing the template three times, and I was able to use quick actions to really quickly make a change without having to go to this massive properties panel that we're all used to, right? You can still use the property panels, it hasn't gone anywhere, but we hope that quick actions on all sorts of controls, and as I click around, you'll see that it appears on, even on my, here, I'll go to zoom, scroll up a little bit, even appears on my page as well, right? So you can change things at the grid level, you can change things at the window level. We know what the common properties are, so we hope you definitely give this a try. All right, so we're done with the very first demo. Let's jump into the second demo. Now, the next set of demos is all about live diagnostics and editing your code while your application is running. So let's go ahead and start our application with the debugger and see how we can do that in Visual Studio 2022. All right, so here's my app. It's running, and right away, I'm gonna notice something that's bugging me. My title is missing. What's going on here? We saw a title in the designer. We know it's using binding to set the title, and we know we have design time data that allowed us to visualize it in the designer, but now in the running app, it's missing. So something is going on with the binding. Let's go ahead and take a look at a great feature in Visual Studio called XAML Binding Failures. XAML Binding Failures is a new experience, relatively new experience that we've added that works really great in this end-to-end scenario that I'm about to show you. So here, I'm already making something that used to be really hard much, much easier, which is seeing that, yes, my binding really is failing. And I'm able to see that inside of this pane. This pane is very powerful. It would show you all the binding failures. It would allow you to scroll through them. It even has the ability to search binding failures. Like if there was more than one here, if I typed into the search box, it would filter down by any of the columns. So you can basically type anything. So it's a really powerful feature that lets you see that a binding really did fail without having to go into your output window and go through the drudgery of having to scroll through this output window and try to find your binding failure. I mean, this is just always painful. Yeah, there it is, right? But like, it would have been really painful for me to find. Now, we also have another great feature. If you're using .NET 5 or .NET 6 with WPF, we're able to actually not only just show you the binding failure, but show you where it's happening. So I'm gonna click on this button right here. This button, I'm gonna zoom in just to show you. If it's visible next to your binding failure, that means we have source navigation available. So I'm gonna go ahead and click it. And my cursor position will move right to the text block where the failure is happening. So that's the first feature I really wanted to show you, the fact that you can easily see your binding failures. Now that we know where it's happening, let's go ahead and fix the problem. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a look at this. Yeah, it looks like a spelling error. So I'm gonna just use IntelliSense to fix it. I'm gonna click equals here on the path, but I'm not getting IntelliSense. Let me show you a second feature I wanted to demo. And this is our ability to bring IntelliSense for your view models, for your MVVM scenario, right into Visual Studio. And this works both at design time and runtime. We're at runtime, so let's go ahead and implement the feature. I'm gonna scroll up to the window. And there's more than one ways to execute this quick action, but I like it up here at the window where we get a tooltip that says, would you like to set, and I'm gonna zoom in just to show you, set design time data context. So yes, in this case I do. So let's go ahead and click that again. And hit enter on it. So now I have a design time data context. So don't worry, it works at runtime too. And I'm gonna scroll back to where the error was, and I'm gonna hit equals one more time. And now that I'm hitting equals, look at that, I'm getting IntelliSense. I can see exactly what my commands are, what my properties and collections are. It makes it so much easier to fix this bug. I'm gonna go ahead and set the title properly. And now I'm gonna go back to my running application, and there's my title. All right, so that worked out really great. But we're on a roll here. We're gonna go and show you yet one more amazing feature for you XAML developers. I'm gonna switch back to Visual Studio and talk about a scenario that happens very often to me. I'm on a single screen device, I'm on my laptop, and I just don't have multiple displays. I have to keep switching between my XAML code editor in Visual Studio and my app, or I have to dock my app in some awkward way with Visual Studio, and it becomes really difficult. So we've added this new feature. I'm gonna hit Control Q, and I'm gonna type in XAML Live Preview. So XAML Live Preview, which will appear shortly here on the left, and you can choose where to dock it, of course. Well, this is a real-time view of your running application. Let me explain what this is, because some people are not sure exactly how this differs from the XAML Designer. XAML Designer is something that you can use while your app isn't running. But once your app is running, Live Preview gives you the ability to see your running app. So it's not quite a designer. I can't like click here to move things around, but I see what changes I'm making to my application in real time. So let's go ahead and just do a really simple example. I'm going to go ahead and break this text property again. So I'm going to go in here, break the text property, and now it, on the left, you can see the app instantly changed and my running app changed as well, right? It's just mirroring the running application. So you can't interact with it in the live preview experience, but anything you see, if it was an animation or any change, it'll be instantly visible. So let's put that back in. Great, I now have my path. I'm gonna go ahead and hit the clear button to clear my binding failures because I know I've resolved all of them and my application is already slightly better. But now I'm noticing something else. I'm not seeing any of the actual items inside of my app. I know there's a view model, I know I've coded it, and I know it should show data, but for some reason it's not showing the data. Let's take a look at the items control. Well, that's interesting. My items control has no item source being set. Okay, that could be the problem. Let's go ahead and set the item source. I'm gonna type in item source, and I'm gonna do the binding here. And look at that, because I had IntelliSense, I was just able to tab right into the results. And because I have live preview, I can see that my running app has been updated to show the items. Very, very powerful. Think about it. You were able to get IntelliSense for your problems, see the problems as you fix them in real time. So this combination of XAML binding diagnostic, XAML hot reload technology, and XAML live preview will hopefully make you very, very productive. But looking at my application, and let's zoom in a little bit. Something is a bit wrong. Los Angeles, okay. I know I have better data than that, so my data is wrong. Now, okay, that could be a problem, right? Typically, if you need to change your C# code at this point, you would be stopping the debugger, and who knows how long it would take you to rebuild and restart your app. And we wanna save you that time in many situations. And in this situation, I know we can. Let's go ahead and take a look at our view model. I'm gonna go to my Solution Explorer, and I'm gonna go into my air quality service. And in here, let's see what's going on. Well, that's embarrassing. I have a to-do flag to have removed this code. All right, I'm gonna remove this code. Obviously, that's causing everything to break. I'm gonna make it go away. But now that I did that, I need to apply it to my running application. And this is where we're gonna demo the next feature, which is .NET Hot Reload. Sometimes people call it C# Hot Reload, that's fine. It's basically Hot Reload for your code, right? It works for C# and VB in many situations, and it's powered by a new button we have up here called the Hot Reload button. Let's zoom in and take a look at it for a second. This new button sits next to in your toolbar between like your stop button and your continue button, and clicking on it will try to apply the code changes. Now, there are situations where applying code changes will be too complicated for us to do at runtime, and we'll give you a message, we'll make it very clear to you that we couldn't do it. But in a lot of cases, you're gonna be able to apply it to your running app. Not only that, in many cases, you'll be able to do this even without the debugger. Yes, I know I'm in the debugger right now, and the debugger is great because we get things like XAML Hot Reload, XAML Live Preview, but if you just Control-F5ing, you know, starting your app with that debugger, Hot Reload will still be available to you as a WPF developer. It's not available for every app type yet, but if you're doing WPF, it's definitely available to you. But in this case, everything is wired up and ready. And now I'm gonna show you one more thing, just give you a tip. Now, you can always press this button, and this will hot reload. But sometimes you just want to hot reload on save. It's a pattern that I actually prefer, so let's go ahead and check this box here. I'm going to click back into the button and check off hot reload on file save. By doing that, now this setting is on, and we're just making this is an actual setting. We're making it really accessible to you, so you can turn it on and off as you need to. Sometimes on save is good, sometimes it's not, so you can opt in really easily and opt out really easy out of it. So I've opted in, I've made my code change, I'm gonna do the magic now, control save, and it's done, right? Because it actually worked, right? We didn't receive any messages from Visual Studio, that means my app should be patched. So now I have to switch back to my running app. This is the one time which I do have to interact with my application. And we don't have any way to know which code we should re-execute for you. We can patch the code, but you still need to do some action in your app to re-execute it. That's a really important feature, understanding of the feature for .NET Hot Reload. You've gotta re-execute code you've applied. In this case, it works out great. I have a refresh button. I'm gonna hit the refresh button, and look at that. It worked, right? All the right values are being set. And now, what's important to note here is that This feature didn't require a breakpoint. It applied it to your running application. You could have made much more significant changes than what I showed you. But for the demo purposes, I hope it gets the idea across to you as you're watching out there. All right, so we've fixed quite a few problems. We made the app look better before we even ran it. We've fixed problems in the look and feel after we run the application. And we fixed the code behind. That's pretty cool, I think. All right, so let's now switch pivots one more time. And this is the last set of demos that I'm going to show you. And we're going to now think like a designer. So let's go ahead and go back to Visual Studio. So live preview, it's something that I've shown you very briefly, right? I've shown the fact that you can kind of zoom in and out of your app. So you have the zoom button here, and you can go pretty deep on the zooming if you had to. And you can see your app as things are changing. But it actually has a bunch of great capabilities that I did not show off. So let's talk about which capabilities you have. So there's a bunch of buttons in the top left here. Let's start off by element selection. Element selection allows you to hover over elements and get a nice little preview, just like you would in F12 tools in the web scenarios, of like what the margins are, render sizes, fonts, and backgrounds involved within the item that you're showing. So it's a powerful feature that I haven't shown before today, but now you can see that you can see all sorts of information from the window, from the text block, etc., without ever having to go and look for the XAML. It's basically interpreting what the runtime state of these values are. So it's a really powerful feature. Another amazing feature is rulers. Rulers up here allow you to add both a vertical and horizontal ruler to your application. So this is the rulers, and let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna add a vertical and horizontal just for fun, and I'm gonna make my live preview experience slightly bigger here. So with that, I am going to set my rulers up to some values that I know are important to me. First of all, my designers tell me that my alignment from the left should be about 55 for this first item. And if I make that right, then all the rest of the items will render correctly. So I'm gonna go ahead and just align my rulers to it here, and I'm gonna zoom in, and I'm gonna move so I can see exactly the change. All right, so this doesn't look quite right, right? It's definitely, you know, it's at 55.2, that's fine, right? It's close enough, it doesn't have to be perfect. Let's go back to the XAML file and take a look at what's going on there. So now I'm gonna scroll down to where we are setting the, creating the visual look and feel. I'm gonna make this slightly bigger so that I get my scroll bar back. All right, let's scroll over here to the right. All right, so here's my AQI value. So now I know I'm working with the right thing. And as you can see, I see my running app, and if I start to play with the margins, which are probably the thing that's wrong, well, that should show me in real time an improvement. So I'm gonna go ahead and set this margin to be, and by margin, I'm just gonna zoom in. Just literally, I'm just changing the margin to see what happens on the left. I'm gonna make this 5. From the left. Okay, that moved a little bit, right? Let's make it 6, moved a bit more, 7. I'm gonna make it slightly more, let's make it 8. Oh, 8 looks perfect, right? I mean, again, it's not 100% perfect, but I'm sure nobody will notice. And I've got a great improvement here in my app using these rulers. And the rulers might sometimes blend in, so I have things like I can change the color of the rulers. If I want the rulers to be red or yellow, I can go ahead and do that. So you can really always see the rulers and make quick changes to them. You can remove a ruler, I can click on this and hit the delete button. And by selecting the ruler with a mouse click and then hitting delete, it removes it. There's also a little X that appears here, you can click on that as well. So now I got rulers out of the way. Let's zoom out and take a look. All right, that looks great, actually. All of my items are now, AQI value is slightly more to the right, exactly how my designer wanted it to be. So once again, I was able to use live preview and XAML hot reload together to make all this possible. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed all the demos we just saw. And here we have some resources. These are links to documentation for basically all the features that I've shown you. So definitely check them out if you're interested. And we really hope you try Visual Studio 2022 that will help you make great XAML applications. Thanks so much for watching.